Fáilte agus díobh to our Bish Christmas Mass. We especially welcome this morning our Bish brothers of different faith traditions and of none. We are glad you're with us in fraternity, paving new paths of hope and peace. We welcome and thank our school chaplain, Father Sean, for kindly facilitating our Eucharist celebration this morning. We come together as a school community to continue our preparation for the coming of Jesus at Christmas. We are called to rejoice in the Lord. Let us gather now in prayer as we continue to prepare the way of the Lord with faith and with hope. The theme of our celebration is the mantra of St. Julian of Norwich. All shall be well. All manners shall be well. We begin our celebration by lighting our Advent wreath.
As we light our Advent wreath, we are reminded that while we come to the end of the calendar year 2020, a new liturgical year begins with the season of Advent, a time of preparation for the birth of Christ, the light of the world, a time to journey in our hearts and minds towards Christmas, a time to nurture our faith. Christmas has a taste of hope because for all the darkness in our lives, God's light shines forth. His gentle light does not frighten, but draws us to a love that brings light to our lives and peace to our hearts. All shall be well, and all manner of things shall be well. Let us proceed with our Eucharistic celebration with hope and faith.
Lowly manger in all large ways. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everybody, and I welcome you to our celebration of the Eucharist here in the Bish. It's a great privilege for me to be here as the chaplain, and I just wish to assure you that I'm offering this Mass for all the staff, the students, and all those associated with the Bish School. We have just celebrated the rite of lighting the Advent wreath, and I'm going to bring that penitential rite to a conclusion with the Bedouin prayer. I ask the great God for pardon. I ask for pardon at sunset, when sinners all turn to him. I ask God for pardon now and forever. O Lord, save us from our sins, protect our children, and take care of those friends of ours who are not very strong. Let us pray. During the season of Advent, which is a season of hope, as we look forward to the birth of Christ, may we learn to place our trust in God, who never leaves us or abandons us. May we be open to learning from all our experiences and come to understand that God speaks to us through all the events of our lives, be they good or bad. In this way, we can face the future with confidence, knowing that God will give us what we need each day. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
O little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark streets shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. Once in Royal David City stood a lowly cattle shed, where a mother laid her baby in a manger for his bed. Mary was that mother mild, Jesus Christ, her little child. Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet head. The stars in the bright sky looked down where he lay, the little Lord Jesus asleep in the hay.
While shepherds watched their flocks by light, all seated on the ground, the angel of the Lord came down and glory shone around. We three kings of Orient are, bearing gifts we traverse afar. Field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. O star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light.
Anyone who follows me will have the light of life.
Hallelujah. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I bring good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favours." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today is the 18th of December and is only the second day of the latter part of Advent, the time from the 17th of December to the 23rd or 4th, where we now turn our full attention to preparing for the feast of Christmas. Jesus was born in poor surroundings, a dependent child of poor parents, far away from home, and soon to be a refugee in Egypt. By choosing to be born into such poverty and away from the limelight, God's Son turns on its head the world's view of fame and success. The first visitors to share in Mary and Joseph's joy were the shepherds, rough country folk, viewed by many with suspicion. Their presence this night is an assurance to us that Jesus is available to ordinary working people. Furthermore, God was sending a clear message that in Jesus he was going to take the side of the poor and the disadvantaged in our society. What we celebrate on December the 25th is more than just an historical event that happened in Bethlehem over 2,000 years ago. It is a reminder that God loves each and every human person on this planet, and that he sent his own Son to come down, live among us, save us from our sins and our sorrows, and show us the way back to our heavenly home. In compassion, Jesus revealed to us that his Father is a loving God who only wants us to experience the depth and the intensity of his love without any strings attached. God's love for each and every one of us is unconditional. Christians focus not only on what Jesus did by becoming one of us, but also on what we must do as part of God's family. This means that we must look out for our fellow human beings. We must constantly question ourselves about how we treat other people. The consequences of our daily living are enormous. To neglect the elderly, to ignore the poor and the homeless, and to have no thought for the 15% of our people that may be unemployed going into the new year. To have no thought for those whose Christmases will only be a time of loneliness and depression, is to ignore those individuals with whom Christ has so closely identified himself and with whom he spent so much of his public life. We will also need to examine ourselves on the doors that we close off to Christ. There is little to be gained from being sentimental about the doors slammed in the face of Mary and Joseph in Bethlehem when there is no room in our own hearts for the poor, the homeless on our streets, and those who find themselves in any type of need. The happiness and the peace of Christmas come from within, when God is born into the stable of our own hearts. I want to just share with you a conversation that took place when I was standing in a long queue coming up to the Christmas. It started by one of the individuals concerned confiding in his friend how upset he was to see the homeless on the streets of our cities. "Can no one help them?" he asked. His friend said, "It's not that simple." But the other person said, "You know, I like to help people whenever and however I can." His friend said to him, "But you have nothing yourself. You are in fact poor. How much do you have in your pocket at this present moment?" The other person answered, "I am not poor. I may not have much money, but I have a ticket in my pocket to return home. I have work." And his other friend said to him, "But you are still very poor. You are barely making enough to pay your bills. How much have you left?" "I had 5 euro, but I could not pass the homeless man on the street without giving him that small amount." His friend said to him, "I don't understand. You are so poor yourself, and yet you gave away all the money you had to a homeless person on the street." I listened to the conversation and thought that the birth of Christ was taking place at that moment in that person's heart. And as we ourselves journey to celebrate the feast of Christmas, we ourselves have to ask ourselves the same question. What do we want to do? How will we respond to the gospel of Jesus if we wish Christ to be born into our hearts? I was very struck by the conversation because it reminded me vividly of what Jesus had said almost 2,000 years ago as he stood outside the temple in Jerusalem. And various people were coming along to give large sums of money into the temple collection. But a widow came along and she put in a small coin. She put in all that she had. It was very interesting that this passage of the gospel was made live and real in 2020 by two people having a conversation as I stood in a queue. And that scene will stay with me because it makes for me the season of Advent, it makes it a very real thing. And only each of us here this morning can answer how as Christians we will respond to that story and to the call of Christ to help out our neighbour. Yesterday I was doing some work with the 6 years and I wanted to say something on Advent because I knew they wouldn't be present this morning to us, but of course they are included in my thoughts and prayers. And I used a prayer with them and I thought it was a lovely way to conclude my homily because it challenges each and every one of us to answer the gospel. Help me to hear the words and to follow the actions of Jesus. Help me to repent of my sins so that I may clearly see the way to walk, the truth to speak, and the life to live for him who is our Lord Jesus Christ and whom we hope and trust will be born into our hearts this Christmas. Amen.
Lord, let us pray for all staff, students and members of the Bish community this Christmas. May they be safe and well during the holidays. Lord, heal us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, let us pray for all families who have been affected by COVID. May they be comforted and cared for this Christmas. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, let us pray for the Patrician Brothers and the members of Augustinian Order, that they may find strength in the work they do at home and abroad. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, let us pray for our family members and our friends who are no longer with us. May our tears be wiped away and our mourning be turned into joy. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, let us pray for those in need during this time. May our hearts be open to generosity and kindness, as we are all one in Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, as we bow our head, Lord, let us pray that we will embrace the great honour we can give Almighty God, to live gladly because of the knowledge of his love. Lord, graciously hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
As we bow our heads in prayer, let us think of the prayers the students have read here today. We ask God to look over us and to guide us by his presence during this time. And we make these and all our prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work with human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice endures may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Father in heaven, we offer you these gifts now that we bring before you as we come to celebrate the Eucharist in preparation for the feast of Christmas, and we ask your blessing upon these gifts through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Brendan our Bishop, all the clergy, and all God's people. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Waiting for Christmas by Liam Glynn, our former colleague. Waiting for something to happen. Waiting for the alarm to ring, for the microwave to ping. Waiting for the bus to come, to go. For the drink can to drop, for the class to begin, for the morning bell. For the taste buds to wake to your sandwich, your cake. For the text to say yes, for the long ball, the cheers. Waiting for the computer to hum, for that warm dinner to come. Waiting for sleep. And soon for parents, turkey and laughter. A family waiting for their flooded home to dry out. A man waiting, hoping for a new job. A woman waiting for her baby, beautiful and new. And Joseph and Mary waiting. For the day to dawn, for the donkey's journey to begin, his slow, steady walk. For the innkeeper to say, come in. Waiting for the cows to make space for Mary to rest. Waiting for Christmas. The wait is nearly over for the good, the joyful, and the simple things in life, family.
Let us pray. Come, Lord Jesus, do not delay. We entrust ourselves to your love. Strengthen us by your advent and raise us up, for you live and reign with the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. And just before I give the final blessing, I would just like to thank the management and the staff of the Bish for preparing such a wonderful liturgy, and to wish all the staff of the Bish and all the pupils of the Bish a very happy and a holy Christmas on my own behalf and on behalf of the Augustinian community. And for those of you who do not share in the Christian tradition, I hope that you have a wonderful time and a wonderful holidays as you go home to be present to your families and friends. May the Almighty and merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son, and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent and enrich you with his blessing. Amen. As you run the race of this present life, may he make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity. Amen. So that rejoicing now with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. The Mass is ended. Go forth in peace.
And just before our final hymn, we'd just like to present the John Paul II Awards to six of our senior students. The John Paul II Awards are given to young people who give willingly and voluntarily to their local parishes. Tasks undertaken by our lads this year included cleaning the local church, participating in the church choir, reading at Mass, attending their school retreat, organising school November Remembrance Tree. They organised the Team Hope shoebox appeal, the St Vincent de Paul food appeal, the Headstrong Christmas decoration competition, and they've carried out outreach work and undertaken coaching roles. Each of the five students today have shown leadership and commitment to others in achieving this award. They've been great ambassadors for our school in everything they have done. So it's with great pride and pleasure Mr Madden and myself will present the awards to the lads, and I'll just ask Mr. Madden to take over from here.
Just, it's my great pleasure this morning to, and I have here a letter from the Bishop of Galway, Brendan Kelly. The John Paul II Awards are run in each diocese in Ireland. And I'm going to read Bishop Brendan's letter. Dear Niall, Connor, Shane, Evan and Dara, Congratulations on completing your projects for this year's John Paul II Awards. Because of the present COVID-19 restrictions, we are unable to hold an award ceremony as we would have done in previous years. But I wanted, nonetheless, to take this opportunity to thank you for your participation and dedication. This wasn't an easy year to participate in the awards. And a word of thanks must also go to your teacher, Emily Fitzpatrick, who kept you animated at all times. I would love to be with you on today for the presentation of the certificates and medals, but unfortunately, that won't be possible either. However, let me assure you of my prayers. May the Lord bless you now and always, and have a very happy Christmas. Le Gach Chia Hui, Brendan Kelly, Bishop of Galway, and Kilmacdua, an Apostolic Administrator of Kilfenora. So first, no particular order, we'll take Dara Cleary. Sorry, Dara, just one second now. So well done, congratulations.
Thank you. Dara.
Next, we'll take Evan Ford. Congratulations,
thanks,
Evan.
Sir. Well done.
Niall McGinn.
Well done, Niall.
Well done, Niall. Congratulations. Connor Moran. Well done, Connor. And Shane Carroll.
And can we just say, Shane, all the lads have got bronze awards for doing 16 hours in their local parishes, and Shane has got the gold award for doing 20, so I'll give that to Shane. Well done, Shane.
Congratulations, Shane. Great achievement. Well done, sir. Just before we finish up this beautiful ceremony here this morning, there's a few people I'd like to thank. I'd like to thank Father Sean for his work this morning, but also for his work throughout the year. He is a wonderful addition to the staff at the school, and we're delighted to welcome him here on his weekly visits. And we continue and hope that that will improve as the years, the months and years progress. I'd like also to thank the teachers involved in preparing the ceremony this morning, to Miss Maura Nieda, to Miss Grania Cotter, to Mr. Seamus Callaghan, Deputy Principal. Without their work, this wouldn't have happened. I'd like also to thank Cormac Staunton, who has enabled, his professional expertise has enabled this ceremony to go ahead this morning, to be shared throughout the three buildings of the school, and indeed to anyone else who's tuned in from our invitation. I'd like to wish you all a healthy and happy Christmas. Hopefully the year 2021 will bring more joy and certainly a sense of hope. It has been a difficult year. We have navigated the pathways hopefully safely, and I would like to wish you again, as I said, a happy and healthy Christmas for you and all your family. Cormila Mogad.
Beautiful song.